Hello! Today I'll show you the new features introduced in Home Assistant 2023.2 release. I'll start with the smaller changes first, and I'll gradually go to the biggest ones. So, buckle your belts, as this new release is full of exciting new things, and I can't wait to tell you more about them. The first new feature in Home Assistant 2023.2, and probably the smallest one this month, is the added possibility to change the sensor precision straight from the Home Assistant UI. If you have sensors or entity that have digits after the decimal, you can now decrease or increase that to whatever number you wish. Have in mind that this setting is not just limited to your dashboard. It affects everything that uses the entity, including automations and scripts. Next new feature is streaming history. In other words, the graphs we used to see in history section are now updating live, and you can watch them change right before your eyes. That may seem like a small change, but actually it is not, and it is yet another functionality added to this domain in the latest Home Assistant releases. It also helps writing less data in the Home Assistant database, prolonging the life of your storage that way. Which is kind of cool, don't you think? Remember, the further we go in this video, the more interesting new features we are going to see. That is according to me. Of course, your ranking can be different, so watch the entire video and share what's your favorite new Home Assistant 2023.2 feature in the comment section below. Next new thing is a sensor groups feature. By going to Helpers tab, I can create a group of sensors, numbers or number entities. This is a great way to keep track of multiple sensors at once and to sum them or average them, for example. It is also possible to enable this ignore non-numeric toggle option, and this can be a really handy feature if some averages are calculated and one of the sensors became unavailable. With this switch turned on, the sensor will be ignored, preventing any inaccuracies in the data. The type of the group can also be changed from a drop-down menu, so you can customize your sensor group the way you like it. Do you know that I created a smart home glossary which contains over 60 smart home terms and abbreviations and their simple but useful explanations? Do you also know that you can instantly download that smart home glossary from my website, automatelike.pro/glossary, absolutely free of any charge. The link can be also found in the video description, so go get it and use it every time you see a strange smart home word somewhere in the internet. Back to the new features in Home Assistant 2023.2, where the next one is kind of important, especially if you're using ESPHome devices, because from now on, the ESPHome is even more integrated. If you have Home Assistant ESPHome dashboard add-on installed, then Home Assistant will know about it and will pull automatically the encryption key. So you don't have to care about that process anymore, and you don't have to copy and paste the encryption key when adding new ESPHome devices in Home Assistant. Also, API password option should not be used anymore in the ESPHome configuration. Until now, if someone gets your API password or you share it with someone, all of the ESPHome traffic will become kind of unencrypted. With Home Assistant 2023.2, if you have API passwords configured, then a new repair notification will pop up and it will ask you to upgrade your configuration so that the API passwords to be removed and only encryption key to be used instead. And that encryption key, as I already said, it will be used automatically by Home Assistant and you don't have to care and worry about communication encryption anymore, as it will just works. Also, you'll be able to update your ESPHome devices directly from Home Assistant. And one final touch regarding the ESPHome. Visit button inside Home Assistant is updated. If you click on it, you'll be redirected to the web server of the ESPHome device. But if you don't have web server configured for your ESPHome device, the ESPHome dashboard will be opened instead. Before I go to the start of the show, that's the new Assist functionality, which will allow us to control Home Assistant in our own language, I want to invite you to my Home Assistant webinar, where I'll discuss the different installation types of Home Assistant, plus one not very popular but stupid easy way to get started with Home Assistant if you don't have such installation yet or you want to quickly spin a test installation. Visit my website automatelike.pro/webinar and register right now. My webinar is completely free. Now, straight to the new Assist functionality that, if you remember, will allow us to control Home Assistant with our voice eventually. You can access Assist from the icon in the upper right corner of Home Assistant desktop or from the three dots menu if you are on a mobile companion app. From the Assist, you can start typing commands. For example, turn on or off devices or even whole areas. This can be used in different languages. Currently there are 39 and counting. By default, the language set on your device operating system will be used. For now, if you want to stay entirely local, then only typing of commands is supported. Otherwise, voice commands by using Google Assistant or Siri engines are also allowed. Both platforms will support Home Assistant with the latest iOS and Android Home Assistant companion app updates. Using them, you'll be able to say, "Hey Google, Assist," or "Hey Siri, Assist," and then the command you wish the Home Assistant to execute. Of course, any devices that supports Google Assistant or Siri can be used. And these devices are a lot. Smartwatches, smartphones, tablets, voice assistants, set-top boxes, and so on. The default sentence pack of Assist contain all of the basic commands like turn on and off devices and areas, set brightness and colors and so on. The good thing here is that the allowed sentences or commands are based on text files and templates, and you can create your own sentences that can do some custom stuff for you. That means if you want to have different ways to turn something on or off, you can do that with a custom sentence. It is also possible to create a whole script or to invoke an automation with multiple actions that will be executed because you set simple custom words or commands. After all, this is just the beginning and I'm sure more exciting updates in that area will follow soon. If you want to see more Home Assistant videos, check this playlist of mine that I created just for you. I'm Kiryu, see you next week. Bye!